us are bringing the diamonds and all those things. And the guru lived happily ever after.
And you're nothing will come, don't worry. Don't break the wall. We had two disciples continuously fighting with each other. One day, unfortunately, he told them to press both feet. One is just massaging his feet. The other one was also massaging. Suddenly, this guy looked up and said, the guy, the other guy, oh, you're staring at me? And this guy, huh? You are staring at me? The other guy, what? What you can do? Duck! Oh, only you know how to break? God, you think I don't know? Let me also? Over. Finally, who is suffering? Masters both like them. So, the real thing which you are supposed to be afraid, frightened is disciples. Unless the sun goes down, you can't meditate. Once married, both fellows get trained. One chisels the other. Chiseling goes on. Alright, now let us work on Nirvanik Sarira. See, actually when you pass away, when you land upon this body, no obstruction is there. Nothing stops you. Except, only one thing you need to understand. Actually, nothing stops you. Only one thing, you should have the courage to break from the past. When it comes to nirvanic body, nothing stops you. You have no problem. Even the problem of bliss disappears. In that area, even the problem of joy disappears. Nothing is there. Only one thing, sometimes you don't have so much of courage to take the jump. You don't have the courage to break from the past. Courage to break from the past is what is necessary. When you come to Nirvanik Sarira, if you can break yourself from the past, simply will dissolve into the existence, into the Parashakti. You will become one with the cosmic energy or the cosmic Shakti. Whatever you call it, God, whatever name you may give, you will become one with that divine energy. This Nirvanik Sarira is literally, if you stay in this sarira, you are almost enlightened. It's like you become so porous, so vibrant. There is no difference. Only one thing, with this, in this body, if you stay, continue to stay, you will not be able to dissolve totally. Lot of enlightened masters stay in this body itself to help the world and some purpose. For some reason, they stay in this body itself. Few disappear, totally disappear. Many, they stay in this nirvanic body itself. But even staying here will not be a complete enlightenment. Even that will not be a complete enlightenment. Courage to take jump, break free from the past, only gives you the capacity or the power to enter into the final experience or enlightenment. Now let us see. You have a big notebook in front of you. Wake up call. All of you have your notebooks in your hands. See, you have written so much about your life, your desires, your guilt, your pain, your joy. You have such big list. Now, let us come to an understanding. After reading all this book, what do you feel? Is your life worth living?
Yes.
What? Yes. You say? Just look. If you look, which is more? 51%, which is 51% and which is 49? 50-50. Sure. That is what? Let me ask in a clear cut way. Who feels the life is really worth living? Who feels that a bliss portion is more and the pain is less?
No,
what I am telling you, joy is more and the pains are less. Who feels? Raise your hands.
After writing it.
No, I am asking about your real life. Real life. Raise your hand. How you live, you see, you should be very clear. Now come out very clearly. Seeing your whole life, seeing this whole thing, you feel it is worth living all the sufferings which you underwent. Is it worth undergoing for this life? Come out clearly.
No.
So many hands you raised.
Only if there's a whole purpose. It's not a yes or no answer. It depends. If this is the path to enlightenment and you have to go through it, then it's worth it.
But you are not gone through, you are not went near enlightenment.
That's what I'm saying, but if we are working towards enlightenment, then and if it's necessary that we have to suffer.
That is different. That is different. But now you are not working towards enlightenment.
No, trying.
Swamiji, since we all along we thought there was no choice, we felt it was worth living. But now that we have a choice, certainly not worth living.
And now comes the intelligent answer. So two things. One group feels it is not totally worth living. The other group feels, you can't say worth living, but okay. So, okay. One group says, surely suffering is more, it is not worth living. For you people, solution is break from the past. Break from that past. Break the mental setup. Let us come out of this mental setup. A big doubt raises. Can I come out? Is it possible? It is possible. When you can feel so much of pain with just few words, just entering into one meditation, when you can feel so much of pain, suddenly, out of nowhere, whole body is filled with pain. When that can happen, why not this? We always have a doubt. We can't break from the past. You may be having a smoking habit. You would have tried 2-3 times. Fourth time you decide, I can't do anything about it. I can't do anything about it. You decide. If you feel that the life is really not worth living, break from your old mental setup. We have a big doubt. Can I break? That's a big problem. Beautiful example by Buddha. He says, it is you who created the knot. Can't you open the knot? It is you who created the knot. Can't you open the knot? Simply you can open the knot. Your mind has got only one power over you. That is your faith on it. That's all. Except your faith on it, it has got no other power over you. The more you believe, the more it has got power over you. The more you decide to change, naturally you got the capacity to change. Every single moment, again and again, you are only creating the same setup. Never think mind has got its own setup. Mind is actually dead matter. Please be very clear. Mind is a dead matter. Mind is just dead matter. It has no life. But when you don't change, it continues the same pattern. It continues same pattern. It's like a, you don't work, you don't change. It's like you put a tape recorder, cassette. Till you stop, it will continue the same music. Only when you interfere, it will stop. You will be able to stop it. Same way, your mind is also just a dead setup. It continues, continues, continues till you break it. So if you feel it's not worth living, break it. Next group, the group which feels okay. If you want something more to be achieved, again, break it. Unless the seed breaks, tree cannot sprout. Unless the tree, seed breaks, tree cannot sprout. Seed says, no, no, let the tree come, only then I will sprout. And the tree says, no, no, unless you break, I can't sprout. Fight continues. Master is a man who has already become tree. So he comes to give assurance to the seed. Don't worry, break. I also had the same problem. I broke, now I became tree. You will not die, break. I am here to take care. Master is an assurance. Master is a promise. Master is a possibility to show, to prove to you it can happen. You can sprout. You can break free from your past. Don't bother. Just break the whole old mental setup. Thousands are able to. You can also do it. Only thing, put your whole effort, put your all your energy to break instead of supporting. That's a beautiful proverb. Satti sutta gada, kai vitta gada. The party is burning naturally. Drop it over. Nobody is asking you to hold it. Be a little more intelligent. Drop this old mental setup. If you can drop, what happens in you is what I call cognitive shift. Cognitive shift. That is what? Living with a new kind of mental setup. You don't have to create a new mental setup. Just drop the old. Creating new is my responsibility. Automatically it will happen. Automatically your intelligence will come up. You are supposed to do only one thing. Put your whole effort without sleeping into breaking free from the past. Breaking from the past. Inch by inch, relive the whole past and bring them out to drop into the to dissolve, to surrender into the existence. Breaking free from the past is one of the important thing in the early times. Anybody who is initiated into Gayatri is called Dvija. If you are given Yajnavalkya, you are called with the name of Dvija. Means what? He has taken the next birth, twice born. This is the real initiation, Diksha. If you have taken Diksha, you became twice born. The first birth is given by father, mother. Accidental. Unconscious. The second birth is given by Guru. Conscious. Clear? Decisively. That is why we call Guru as a father and mother. First birth is unconscious. It is not under your control. But the second birth can be conscious. It's under your control. Bring your whole energy up to break free from the past. To break from the whole past. One more thing. Whatever you call worthy things in your life now, including your joy, nothing is going to come with you. Nothing is going to come with you. Whatever you return joy is based on some time and space. To particular time, to particular space, you think anything is going to come? Anything is going to come with you? No. Nothing is going to come. So if you can break from this mental setup, it will bring a totally new awareness and consciousness into your being. Breaking free from the past, breaking free from the old mental setup is what liberates you from this nirvanic body. The courage to take the jump, the courage to break from the past is what is necessary when you penetrate the nirvanic body. When you penetrate the physical body, the capacity to bear the pain, in the pranic body, the energy to not to be moved by the desires, the mental body, guilt, you should have the power to heal the guilt, and the etheric body, pain, power to go beyond the pain, causal body, power to go beyond the darkness, and the cosmic body, power to go beyond the joys, nirvanic body, capacity to break from the past. Ultimately, this is the key. This key, if it is used properly, the whole thing will be changed. Simply, you can enter into the new mental setup, new kind of life style, new kind of being, new level of consciousness. Actually, I am creating a possibility, I am creating a space in which you can take the jump from mind to no mind.